John Wall, played under Coach Cal, the BBN stand.
That's Big Blue Nation.
Deserves number 8. Happy for Coach Cal, DeMarcus Cousins, a teammate of Wall's. Oh yeah, this one for all the Cal haters. Who got the last laugh now? Congrats, Coach Cal. Marcus Canby, who played for Cal at UMass. Congrats to Coach Cal, your first, of many national championships. For more, let's go back to New Orleans. Reese Davis is with Dick Vitale.
Dick Vitale alongside Kentucky wins a national championship. It's 8. Wildcats used to it. John Calipari might not be. Calipari's had it slip away a couple of times. Finally, that elusive championship. How does that change the way people will regard him as a coach?
Well, you know, I think there's certain people out there automatically have a certain perception about him. I mean, I get all kinds of tweets about cheating and about all that jazz, vacating the Memphis Final Four, vacating the one at Massachusetts, even though the NCAA certainly has not implicated him in any way. They have even given a letter to that fact that he did not have anything to do with the Rose situation at Cammy. As far as I'm concerned, my perception, the guy is a terrific coach. And I think people have to understand, when you could take, Reese, a bunch of young kids, new people, and blend them as a team in such a short period of time and have them play defensively like they do, where they play as a unit, and play as a, it's not individually, they play as a rhythm. They play together, they play as a unit, and I'm telling you something, that takes coaching. He can motivate, he can inspire, and we know he can flat out recruit.
When you look at this group of young kids that came together to form a championship team, is it that characteristic? Is it that more than their talent that allowed them to play at such a high level over such a consistent period of time?
You know, Reese, it has to start the formula with talent. I mean, obviously, these are talented players. They were all prolific scorers on a scholastic level, dominant players. But he gets them together to understand roles, strengths, and weaknesses, and gets them to blend as a unit. He takes a kid like Miller, who could start for any school in America, and convinces him psychologically, you are a starter, even though you're coming off the bench. You're a starter. You're one of 6 people on his team. There are a lot of kids that wouldn't be able to handle that, veteran players, but he handles it and his players exceptionally well. He's a masterful communicator. I think that's his greatest strength.
In about 30 seconds, what was the best thing that Kentucky did in the game that allowed them to win the national championship?
Being aggressive offensively, the defense is a stabilizer, and we know that's going to be here. But their unbelievable aggressiveness offensively, Jones was aggressive early, Teague was aggressive, Lamb was aggressive, Kid Gilchrist, they didn't get any scoring on Anthony Davis, but those other people set the tempo and the timing for the effectiveness that they had, and now they celebrate as uno number one.
You know, there are 2 things that I did not think would be possible. I did not think a guy could be named the most outstanding player of the Final Four, making only 1 field goal in 10 attempts, and I didn't think that same guy could make a unibrow all the rage. If you're going to play that way, everybody ought to just grow one. Everybody in Kentucky will, because the Wildcats are national champions for the 8th time. 3 goggles?
Yes, sir.